My mother-in-law? I think she passed away, but a cranberry sauce recipe never dies. Here it is again in case you missed it the first 20 times. First, you boil 4 gallons.
I used to like cranberries in a compote sauce or jelly. I used to like the way they'd slither down into my belly. But after 20 years of hearing Susan's recipe, them little fruits have got a lot less taste appeal for me. Now I too love my mother-in-law and want to see her shine. But do you see me trying to push her Loganberry wine? Nothing's good enough to flog for 2 decades or more. So this year, protest, get your cranberry sauce down at the store.
Shut up, Susan, go away, it won't be any loss if we never hear again about your goddamn cranberry sauce.
Oh, I'm telling you, it gets better every year. It's absolutely delicious.
It's getting to the point where when Thanksgiving comes around, I can't listen to NPR because I fear the sound of Susan Stamberg giving us just one more variation of her annual cranberry torture of the people of this nation.
Don't forget the horseradish. Lots of horseradish fresh. That's very important.
Sometimes at night I dream about the coming final days. I rise and grab my AK-47 in a haze. I climb atop a tower and with crazy howls of glee, I blow the heart out of every big old cranberry I see.
Shut up, Susan, go away, it won't be any loss if we never hear again about your goddamn cranberry sauce.
Can't we all just move along?